one day, we were with Floyd, me and my dad. And Floyd was like, oh, AB got this guy he want to spar you. He outside. I'm like, what's his name? He's like, Javonte Davis. He's like, is he good? I'm like, yeah, he good. Like, remind you, when I went to Baltimore, he touched me up. So I'm thinking like, yeah, he good. So then he like, you want to spar? I'm like, yeah. I didn't have my bag. I didn't even know that we was gonna go to the gym or nothing. We was just kicking with Floyd one day. And so my dad went. I went to the gym with Floyd. My dad went to go get my boxing bag, get all my shit to spar from the house, and then he brought it to the gym.
So, I wanted to go get some cash because I was ready to bet. You know what I'm saying? Not just what I did. Mm-hmm. Yeah. That go too. Ahead.
That's when we sparred. It was doghouse rules. Fight to the finish. First person to stop loses. And as my dad would say, we left with the cash.
Oh, so it was money bet. Absolutely.
And you know, when you win in a sparring match, you gotta be clear. It ain't no winners in sparring. Right.
And I'm gonna tell you where I won the money. I won the money from. It ain't no suck. It's AB Daddy and Lee. Levi. Coach Levi. And AB's father. Yeah, you know what I'm saying? So this ain't no fake shit, man.
Anyway, I know it was recorded, huh?
Yeah.
Floyd got the recording and this reporter named Ellie said that he got the every time we ask him where the footage at, he's talking about always in his phone. But you know, he takes minutes, so that's why he's behind the footage. I got 20,000 for everybody. Anybody that came up with the footage.
You come over with the footage, you got 20 grand.
It's one more person that got it. It's AB guy. AB guy, he had a cameraman at that time. And I saw him in traffic one day. And he was like, hey, I'm just playing with you. I can't get you money. So we was at a fight. It was fans was approaching me and stuff like that. So
I want the real
was
fight.
Was it?
I want to make it happen. Because that doghouse shit
first
is
person
brutal.
To quit. First person to quit.
Oh, thank you. Quit?
Was the first person to quit.
I'm up here holding shit down and you quit, Tay? Fuck is going
on? I just told you we got some money on it, man. This shit is for real.
Opposite each other. Fury on the attack, going to the head of Deontay Wilder. Tonight, and it has worked to near flawless perfection. Now Fury's looking to split the guard as Wilder's in bad shape. This the fight is over. This TKO victory. There is only one. Crown the king, the lone undefeated heavyweight champion of the world, Tyson Fury.
I think that I heard somebody say a while ago, and this isn't somebody who I admire or anything like that, say that you need to be the change that you want to see. We all understand it because it's quite basically what you have to do is be part of the solution rather than the problem. If you feel that there's a situation going on that is not to your satisfaction, I think many of us have a habit of engaging the problem in a way that doesn't actually help find a solution but hinders any solution. Hinders all the parties involved at arriving at some sort of satisfactory outcome. And I think that's what we've got with YouTube and boxing. I say this because I get the feeling that there are quite a few people who are satisfied with the current status quo and willing to take that baggage and garbage into the new year, this new year of ours, 2021. 2020 was a unique year. And it goes beyond rhetoric to say that it actually was a unique, difficult year. It was a year that challenged people socially, in terms of social distancing, economically, in terms of not being able to work all the hours, it changed the way our look at work life and all this other stuff, and politically, with the, well, what we can presume, the end of the Trump era, and what led to Trump's downfall in the US elections, and the challenge to democracy, as a matter of fact, whether the tenets of democracy, the pillars that held up American democracy, were strong enough to withhold the stress test that Donald Trump put it under. And thus far, we're still not sure. But that's by the by. I'm making this video to talk about boxing specifically, and I want to talk about Deontay the Bronzeman Wilder. As I said, I don't want to be negative. I don't want to be part of the problem. I'm not going to suggest, of course, arrogantly, that since I'm not going to pass the problem that when it comes to the underworld, that I'm trying to find some solution. But however, I will make some suggestions, and this is it. First things first, Deontay Wilder needs to change tact, needs to change his story, and actually come clean with himself. I think it's convenient for people to latch onto this narrative that he's selling them, and I honestly believe it was quite disappointing for Deontay Wilder to come out and sort of reinforce the conspiracy theory that he'd been hit with a metal object in the glove and he'd been poisoned, or dare I say drugged. I think that it would have been better if Deontay Wilder kept quiet and kept the mystique and mysterious nature of his intent going. When he sort of subscribed to this very low frequency, low hanging fruit theory of a conspiracy, I don't think it helped. And you know, here's the thing, personally, this is how I see it. If Deontay Wilder was in fact cheated, he helped the cheating along because he knew what type of person Tyson Fury was. I think that if you want to judge Tyson Fury by his history, Deontay Wilder was aware of his history and he endorsed Tyson Fury wholeheartedly. He put Tyson Fury up there as a means to discredit the other person who had actually built the British boxing industry in Tyson Fury's absence. For me, it was one of the most dastardly acts of perfidy that I'd ever seen. And it suggested to me, without a shadow of a doubt, that when it really comes down to it, the whole notion of black unity was a farce. Deontay Wilder proved it beyond any shadow of a doubt, and that still continues to this day. But let me just say this. Deontay Wilder has his fans, and they are diehard fans. And I think 2020 also revealed the danger of human attachment to myth and power, the need to attach themselves to some sort of mythological king. Trump is sort of like the mad king of white America. And Deontay Wilder, both of them having D's to start their name, was sort of like the mad black king of black American boxing. And both of them, in reality, when you think about it, gave the impression of being absolute winners. But when it really came down to it, have been proven to be abject failures. The interview that occurred recently with Sugar Hill, Yvonne Sugar Hill Stewart, the nephew, I believe, of Emmanuel Stewart, was quite revealing. Because I honestly believe that Sugar Hill kept his composure and his demeanor quiet and serene because he understood what was going on. After all, he comes from the city of Detroit and he must have been around a lot of black folk. He understood that despite all the lamentation, accusation, allegation, which I'm pretty certain he would have been aware of online before he actually went onto that channel, he also knew, he must have understood that these people needed something to vent through. Some means to vent and get the anger out because they have been psychologically destroyed with the defeat of Deontay Wilder. So all he had to do was sit there and listen as people vented because he understood, almost as an act of charity, as an act of caring, he understood that these people needed it, and they needed to indulge whatever fantasy, whatever helped them get along to deal with this problem of Deontay Wilder. But setting the fantastic nonsense aside, let's deal with the facts here. Deontay Wilder is a liar. Deontay Wilder kept on lying and switching the story and moving the goalpost. And it doesn't matter how much you argue with the Deontay Wilder fan, a Deontay Wilder fan is like a Trump fan. They'll find a reason to justify why it is that Deontay Wilder was in the right. It doesn't matter how much you prove that the timeline doesn't correspond with what he's saying. As a matter of fact, if you think about it, he has been proven to be the biggest loser of 2020. They will still say but it's somebody else's fault. If worse comes to worse, they'll blame the white man. Yet everybody they attack is black. So, that being said, here's what I believe. In the spirit of trying to be optimistic and positive, I would suggest that Deontay Wilder change his story, come clean with himself and with the public, and move on. I don't think he's ever going to be champion again. I think he's taking his fans for a ride. I don't think that fight's going to happen. And if it does happen, chances are, after this long layoff, he will get beaten again.